mine, KTDC, I was having three charges. KTDC, the Transport Development Finance Corporation, and Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan of Education Department. Among them, the RMSA, which was almost around 800 crore project. That was a bigger one, though it is a low profile one. So a lot of work had to be done at that stage. In spite of that, I think I was able to manage KTDC pretty well. Running around 70 to 100 odd hotels and resorts and restaurants in government sector is pretty tough job. And my predecessor did a decent job, and I had to carry forward and take it to the next level. When I joined, the major source of revenue at that point of time was coming from the beer parlors. And there are only around 12 beer parlors as on April 2017. And that had hit us very bad because of the high court orders and the restrictions and all. From there, today we stand at 53 beer parlors. And that has actually changed the whole revenue income for KTDC. I think that is a big challenge, because getting a beer parlor, finding the ideal place which is marketable, where there is no competitor, and then identifying which are the brands which will sell, and then getting it through the excise department, which has a very stringent law, and then commissioning it and monitoring it was a big task, and I think we could successfully do that. And in the first year, in 2016-17, our operating profits in the first year of my joining, it was 3.15 crores. And 16-17-18, I could make it to 6 crores.
Okay.
And that 6 to 6.03 crores. And that was for, because of, one is beer parlors. Second thing is, we ensured the premium properties ran well. That includes Mascot, Bolga, Tiki, County, Samudra and all. And for them, the big year of Nipah and flood came, and that drew us, there were a lot of perspective changes. I actually felt how the businessman feels. I'm from the revenue service, so at the other side of the chair, I was sitting and happily taxing them and making them pay penalty and all. And when the year of Nipah and flood, that was 1819, I was running a company in government sector with hotels and resorts, which is directly affected by the floods and Nipah. One is, the footfall of travelers was almost nil for 3-4 months. Second is, in Tekadi and Munnar, my properties were affected physically because of the landslides. Third is, I had to utilize all my manpower and the boats and everything which KTDC had for the flood relief. And that was a really good thing which we did, and I'm very happy about that. We could rescue my employees in KTDC. They were so good that some of them were stuck up in some of the midwaters for almost 2-3 days. Still they survived and they did it. So I'm really happy for them. And that was a great year of learning and experience for KTDC. And during the rainy times, unfortunately, the beer sales were also low. So I had to struggle, because unlike other government departments, I had to make my own revenue for paying the salaries. Somehow we brushed through. I mean, that was a great experience. And I think KTDC never had that kind of an issue. Even Kerala never had that kind of an issue. Tour Kerala tours never faced that. Now we are back to our foot, and this year in the first quarter we have around 69 lakh rupees as the profit, and this year we expect to gain around 67 crores as profit. So that is a great experience.
What is the new initiative during this time?
First thing was that we started the new 56 rooms in Mascot Hotels, a new block. At the point of time of my joining, it was only getting completed, and I ensured that it completed in as fast as possible. Then another major one was Ponmudi. Ponmudi, we have only 10 cottages, and it was one of the most beautiful locations near to Kerala. And in fact, there is no location, no hill station so close to the sea where you can reach there in 1.5 hours. Nowhere in the south side, nowhere in the east side or west side you have that in India. But then KTDC property was only having 10 rooms, and it was not becoming economically viable. So we ensured that it was converted into a beautiful property with additional 15 rooms, and it's earning huge profits. So that was another thing which we did. Then there's the Chaitram, which is a hotel which has been which is one of the oldest hotels in town. In all the old Malayalam movies everywhere, it was featuring. And that hotel had around 52 rooms which had to be renovated. That we did. So that is, again, it's a money changer for us. Then we decided that we should have, from the span and breadth of Kerala, we should have something. We already have. So we started a new motel Aram, which is a rest house come restaurant come convention facility in Parshala. And at the same time, we started a new restaurant at Neelesharam. So that is in the both sides. So anybody who lands in Kerala,
okay,
there is a KTDC in
Neelesharam.
That we ensured. Another thing we did was the beer parlors. Most of them were looking like shacks. What we did was we branded it properly. We had a new logo designed. We had the interior chairs and everything changed. Similar branded colors across Kerala. And most of the beer parlors, except a few which are on rendered buildings, which we are planning to shift, we are not done that. But most of the other 90% it is done. And then the proper t-shirt uniforms given to the bearers and everybody. And the ambience and AC was put, because that is one of the necessary conditions. And the snacks were improved upon. So that way the quality of the beer parlors has also improved a lot. So these are the things which we could complete. There are other things which I have started. I am sure that in next 6 to 8 months it will be completed, like the renovation of the waterscapes property. And then the, there are some few Yatri Nivasas of government which was handed over to KTDC, which we had named as Tamarin long back. Some of them were given in the same condition and it has not been renovated. So we are renovating one in Alappi, one in Kannur. And all those renovations will be nearing completion in another 6 months. And then we started a women's only hotel in Trivandrum, first of its kind, where it will be run by women for the women. And the construction is going on. And again, my predecessor will be able to inaugurate that.
Okay. And what about this North Kerala developments in Kannur and
Bekla? The problem with Kerala is always that land acquisition is a major issue. So as far as the Mudipilangad project, which is a dream project of the government, we have completed the land acquisition process. We had pushed through it. There were issues at the local level, but everything has been completed. Now it's ready. Once we get the permit, we can start it. And also in Calicut, we got a land, and also it is ready for starting the job in another 3 to 4 months. Another major thing in KTDC was, being from the revenue service, it helped me. When I see that the audit of KTDC was done only till 11-12, while we was 2011-12 year.
Okay.
While we were sitting in the year 17-18 and 18-19, that is really alarming. A company, a commercial, even though it's in the government sector, it's a commercial company. And the commercial company doesn't have its accounts audited, means that you have no clue where the money is coming and where the money is going. And you will never be able to run into the profit properly if you are not able to manage it. So the first thing I did was that I ensured that there's a problem with the audit. The auditor was changed with a special request to the CAG. They agreed and it was changed, and now almost the audit is almost completed. And this coming March, it's going to be updated. Yeah, so that is one of the biggest challenges in terms of accounting which we could do. And the next most important thing was KTDC has an ERP solution which is years old, maybe ages old, and it does not cater to the new age requirements. The connectivity with the online travel agents is not proper. We don't have a multiple packaging solution there. The revenue management is not there. The channel manager is not there. So many issues were there. So we have finally tendered and given the work order to a company which is catering to many other companies, in the hospitality sector, and that ERP solution hopefully will be implemented very soon. And once it comes in, the revenue leakages will reduce, the marketing quality will improve drastically, and there will be an ease of booking for KTDC, and that will actually will be the base for taking KTDC to the next 30 years.
KTDC is considered as the hospitality phase of Kerala. But last few years, the problem of the marketing part is lack of proper sales and marketing, and the participation of the international travel marts.
See, you can't say that there is lack of marketing. That's not the case. Each KTDC property is a destination within itself. The problem with KTDC was that we were having excellent facilities. The service qualities, whenever we had a focus on it, it always improved. It's not that they can't serve. We are serviced to the best in the country and abroad. We are serviced to foreign presidents. Even the recent presidential visit to Bulgati 3-4 months back that I personally monitored, the kind of service which people in KTDC gave, employees in KTDC gave, the president personally was so satisfied that he sent his appreciation through the governor. See, that kind of service they could. So that means there's no issues with the service. The marketing also, they are doing the marketing, but marketing, the problem was that we were not adding products to our overall thing and rebranding it to make it more attractive. So we have formed new packages. We added new products like Ayurveda, premium corporate and premium cards, which would be lifetime membership cards in KTDC, which has been well taken, even appreciated by the financial.
So that
overall package across Kerala. KTDC, we created a new brand which is being promoted. KTDC is a window to Kerala.
Okay.
It's a window seat to Kerala or window to Kerala. Because just land anywhere in Kerala, there's a KTDC. It can be a 3-star, it can be a 2-star, it can be a wayside amenity. There is a KTDC. You have your home in Kerala. So you don't need to worry. So that kind of product marketing is being done. And hopefully it will bear fruits in the long run. It will not immediate. Of course.
Then there's a travel package, tour packages. Recently you restarted the thing.
No, the tour packages, the buses, that was, I think, it was initially given by the tourism department to KTDC. But then, see, any organization has to take a call when a product is not running properly. It's not that we have to force everything to run.
Okay.
If it's not feasible enough for us, we should be magnanimous to know that and get it out of our platter. What we did,
the outside properties like Chennai and
we only have one property outside with Chennai, which is the Raindrops, which has been doing very well. And it's, I mean, last year it catered us around 1.5 crores of profit, so it's going good. So that's going on.
And
because they will be catering to the local
population.
Well, KTDC travels international travels, and traveling on a tour bus internationally, unless and until you come in a group, it's very difficult. So that was not getting feasible for us. So we immediately took the call. So that's the whole idea. Whenever something is not feasible for us, we decide that it has to be. So that's also an important part in government.
Okay.
So what we did was the tour buses were there. It was not running on a loss, but it was not making profits. So what we decided was maybe the DTPCs. The DTPCs could do it better. No wonder that we have decided, and the Honorable Minister also suggested that that's a good idea, and we have given it to the three DTPCs in Ernakulam, Thrissur and Trivandrum. Basically, there is a base of KTDC has been very stable in the last 2 years. That I am very happy about that, because the structures has been kept in place. There's a lot of issues with respect to the employees also. We always think that a government organization, the union is a bad entity. No. Actually, it is through the union you get the grapevine knowledge. You get actually what is happening. Sitting as an MD here, I will never know what's the name of a waiter or an attendant in Baker. I need to know them. I need to know what is their pulse. Once I know about that, I will be able to take a very wise decision. So, all parties are important for the management perspective. That kind of a management can only be successful. That kind of management can be successful in government.
Okay.
And I think I'm happy
that I did that. Okay. And more about this Muscat Hotel renovation and heritage from this and classic.
So as I told you that we started the new block of Muscat. Then we decided to think what about the old block. Then there's so much of history to the Muscat Hotel. It was started by the British as this army garrison. Then it was converted into a guest house. Then it was converted into the guest house of the government. So that heritage has to be preserved. Even the royal king used to come there and have tea before he goes back. So what we decided was the Honorable CM inaugurated the heritage renovation project of Muscat, and that is slowly happening. And the old block will be renovated to its glory again, while the new block caters to the business community. So that is happening, and for first time in KTDC's history, we got a 5-star. Muscat Hotel got 5-star classification. So far, we never had classification in KTDC. And that was a full-fledged effort of my whole team, and I congratulate them. I am really happy for that. What another thing, major shift in KTDC, the future of KTDC is, KTDC was always into destination development. What was KTDC doing? KTDC, government identifies, or KTDC itself identifies a place or a location or a breach, there is no accommodation facility. Government sometimes supports, and then you start an accommodation facility. Why we have to do it? Because no private player will venture into an unknown place and suffer the losses for the 5 years or 10 years, and he can't survive. So KTDC was the first agency to start hotels and resorts in Kovalam, Munnar, Thekkady, anywhere. So all these beautiful destinations which are on the up of the ranking is only because of KTDC. Now we have almost all the destinations covered with more than enough resorts and hotels. But still there are some, like the Mulpilangad. No private player is willing to invest there other than the homestays. So KTDC is going to do that. So once KTDC property comes in, naturally it will boom up. So that destination will develop.
Destination management is the most important thing ever. Now most needed in Kerala. So what we have identified is that KTDC should be into destination management. So KTDC has decided, or that's the roadmap for KTDC for the future, that destination management will be a major part of KTDC. In this account, we discussed with the Honorable Tourism Minister and the Honorable Finance Minister, and the Honorable Finance Minister in the last budget has declared that KTDC will be part of the tourism management in Kerala. In the budget speech, it is there. And that is a big takeaway from the last budget speech. Not, it's not about the money. It's about the change of role of KTDC. As which, if you take Munnar is so crowded, you require traffic control, you require waste management, you require public control, so many things are required. Only a destination management can do it, and KTDC has to. Private players are having groups, but that won't be enough. So that is where KTDC comes into. So I think I laid down the roadmap for KTDC for the future.
I have worked in quite a few jobs and in government, and also work in the taxation. So one thing I noticed in tourism is, tourism government is not treating the sector as my baba. No. Government very well understands that in Kerala, if tourism is to run, it is to be run by the private sector. Government has to support them. Government supports them in terms of marketing, the destination marketing, product marketing, everything government supports, and putting up the basic infrastructure.